everybody here to support Tracy Malloy's exhibition aptly titled Containment. This is Tracy's second solo show. I was delighted to have been asked to do the honour of opening this exhibition, as I've known Tracy longer than nearly everybody in Westport. I first met Tracy in 1988 in London before either of us had our children. I had no clue then that I would be making this opening speech here in Westport Town Hall Theatre for the talented, vivacious girl that I got to know and admired all those years ago. Tracy is one of those people who stays with you through your life. She is passion personified. From drama, she has made her course through to art. It shows a truly creative character to be able to straddle the disciplines of theatre and visual arts. From what I know about Tracy, she throws herself into everything she does. She becomes totally immersed and explores every angle of whatever she is concerned with. It's now a few years since Tracy became involved in the art world. She completed the art course in Carabay Community College and very quickly went on to sell her work. Her first piece was sold through the annual open exhibition in McGinnis during Westport Arts Festival to a senator of Shamadaran, no less. Tracy works in the area of special needs, and this has a strong impact on her work. She is particularly concerned with planes and texture. This work is open to exploration, and yes, you can touch and feel it, Tracy assures me. There are layers in the paintings, not just visually, but actually. There is a juxtaposition of layers in one painting, various textures to add to the quality of the pieces, and there is a three-dimensional quality there. These are, however, paintings. Tracy would like people to get a healing feel from them. These paintings are for everybody, but are still to be enjoyed by anybody, even people with a visual impairment. Hence the layers and strong texture. Look, feel, and enjoy this work. What comes across to me in this show is Tracy's absolute love of painting. There is love and joy in each piece. Some of the paintings are dark, but there is every colour in black. These are joyful, therapeutic, healing paintings that come from the practice of art therapy and most certainly from the love of art and the heart. The titles of the pieces here are very telling. In Progress, here beside me, the sculptural hand contained on its own plane has possibilities falling from it. It resonates effortlessly with a form that could be man-made or architectural, yet could be a column of water melting into the flat ocean of possibilities. I would like to add, if anybody needs some art therapy, texture, love or passion on their walls, these pieces are for sale at prices that wouldn't cause one too much stress. As somebody famous once said, art enables us to find ourselves and lose ourselves at the same time. Thank you for the art therapy, Tracy. Congratulations and the best of luck with this special version of Containment. I declare this exhibition open.
And even the fact that we brought up how we met back in London, that just threw me back there, so it did. Before I start, I just want to thank Roslyn and Paul for allowing me to have the venue here, and for Paul for having all the work, so he left, I didn't have to do that to get started. Thank you, Paul, wherever you are. And I just want to say thank you very much to my beautiful model, Shauna, the hand. And I was a bit dubious asking her, but she really got into it. It was great, so thank you, Shauna, very much for that. So, the ones that don't, people here that don't know me, my name is Tracy Malloy. I've been living in Westport now going on 28 years. Yeah, it's a long time, it's flown. And here are two of my favourite creations out of five of them. To my daughter Abigail and my daughter Nell. And I'm just going to say, yes, I was big into drama for many, many years. I studied drama back in England. I was going to get on that red carpet. I had my speech, my Oscar in my hand, and I knew exactly what I was going to say. And then I had studied drama for 3 years, and then by pure accident, I was asked to do some performing at a community centre. And I did clowning, and it was for children with disabilities. And whatever happened that day, it just changed my whole concept. And it was just, I had to work in this field. And so yes, I've been working in disabilities now since I was 19. And I've just turned 52 there recently. So that just showed you how passionate I still am with my love of my work. So, I then decided a couple of years back that I wanted to study art. I had was working for an Able Island, and I was with a little boy in a play school in Inishgrown, and he had challenging behaviour. And the reason why he had challenging behaviour was because of his emotions, and he couldn't express himself. And when he couldn't express himself verbally, then it came out in a challenging way and in a very negative way to other children around him, to the staff, also towards me. But what I really saw about the whole thing was, it was how he was, because you could tell by him that he didn't want to be like this, but he had no other way to express himself. So then one day, it was art day on Friday morning, and I had gotten a piece of paper, and he had the choice of paints, crayons or pencils, or even his fingers. And just to see how he was when he was engrossed in his art was completely amazing. He just transformed his whole demeanor, his body language, his facial expressions. He just came into a zone of pure calmness. And you could just even see by his chest that it was slightly raising and slightly going back down with each breath. I was just so amazed by the transformation of him engrossed in his artwork. And then when he had finished, he wanted to do another piece, so I encouraged him to do that. So then I actually talked to a friend then a few years later about art therapy and just how I find myself when I'm engrossed in art. So he encouraged me then to take up the art course here in Westport, level 6, which I did. Met some great people there and still in touch with them to this day. And to be honest, I felt like, oh my God, I can't do this, because there were such talented people in the classroom. And I just felt truly blessed because I learned so much, not just from the tutors, but from the other peers around me. So then I decided to stay another year, and because just towards the end of the year I got really more confidence in my own painting and in ceramics. And then of course my youngest daughter Dare was starting Sacred Heart, so I thought to give her another footing in Sacred Heart and stay and do another year, and that's what I did. So I did that, and I got a portfolio together, and then I applied to Crawford College of Art and Design and did the principles of art therapy, just to give you an idea of what art therapy was all about. So I did that, and then I'd finished, and then at that time, while I was actually doing the art, I had got myself a job with the Irish Wheelchair Association. So I was working on a one-to-one basis with adults with disabilities in their own home, which was completely new to me because I never actually worked with adults in their own home. So it was a new environment for me, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I'm still working there today. And in the meantime, while working, I had the idea that from actually doing the art therapy course, this is how this was all created. So what I learned about art therapy, one thing I learned about art therapy was it's a form of healing. It doesn't cure you, it helps. It helps with expressing oneself. It helps you to focus. It helps with your respiration. It helps with your blood pressure. It helps you to focus on what you're actually doing, so nothing else can get in while you're focusing. It helps with issues. It could be used in so many different areas, from working with somebody with disabilities, working in, say, in rehab, where you know people have maybe drug abuse issues, alcohol issues. You can use it in residential care. There is just so many avenues that you can actually go down with art therapy. It just opens so many doors. And with the other peers there, what we learned with art therapy was, we all had our own ideas and concepts of what art therapy was. My idea was that someone looked at your work and they analysed it and they asked you questions about it and you get deep into it and they'd be saying, why did you use that colour and all this kind of thing. And some of it's kind of true, but some of it is not necessarily needed in art therapy. We had various therapists that came in and did their own work on us, just to give us a taste of the different types of art therapy that's out there. We also had a music therapist, which was unreal, that was absolutely mind-blowing. We all had to sit in a big circle with big African drums and banging, it was just amazing. And one thing I noticed when I was doing that course was I couldn't wait till I got back to Cork again to learn more. It's such a fantastic course. It is so gentle, it is so kind, and it just gives you that hunger to want to know more and more and more. And one thing about me is I always want to learn. I've never lost that passion. I didn't really have it as a child, but as I got older and there's something I want to know everything about it, and I just throw myself into it. And I feel if you throw yourself into it, you get so much back out. So then, when I had finished the art therapy course, I realised that my own work was going to change, because I am such a big fan of texture. I'm a very tactile person, and with my work, I have to be. I have to be tactile because of my clients that I'm working with, especially when it comes to personal hygiene, lifting them, you know, feeding them. So it's a very tactile job. So while I was in Cork and while I was in college here in Westport, I realised that my work has to be tactile. I am sometimes really frustrated that a lot of work is just flat in texture, and I feel that people that have visual impairment, people that can't see, their eyes are their hands. And they need to touch, and they need to feel. So a lot of my projects in college always included texture. And one of my ceramic projects was I picked famous artists, and I had done their well-known paintings like Van Gogh, Starry, Starry Night, out of clay. So I had to make sure that it was all textured, that there was movement, because movement's very important, because the person that's feeling it's got to be able to feel the movement of whatever piece that I had made. So then, when I had decided then to do an exhibition on art therapy, the word containment came straight into my head. And the reason why was we had to be put in groups, and our tutor gave us a piece of paper with a word on it to each group. And we had a pile of newspapers, and we had to make a sculpture around that word and discuss then to everybody else why we made that particular piece. So the group I was in, we had the word containment. And there was only one guy in my group, and he was very masculine. He wanted to say, oh, we're going to make a nest. And I said to him, what about making a big envelope? Because envelope contains things. And he's like, why an envelope? And I said, that's what just came into my head. And then we discussed then with containers how we always buy different containers in our house to put things in. And we consciously think, how the type of container we want, or if there's a container that catches our eye. So there's all different reasons around the word containment. So he decided that he would be going to do a bird and a nest and eggs. So I thought, right, we'll just talk him through this. So the funny thing was then he was making a nest and he was doing this, and I said, the nest is a container. It contains the eggs. So we were making the eggs, and I said, eggs contain the baby birds. And we put the eggs in the nest, and then he was making the bird, and I said, the bird sits on the nest. So the nest is containing not just the eggs, not just the baby birds, but also the bird. And then when the eggs hatch, the eggs are no longer needed, so that container is broken. And then when the egg babies fly away, the nest is no longer needed. And I said, that's what I'm actually going for at the moment, empty nest syndrome. And it was funny because I didn't have a chance to grieve that my son was leaving home to go to college. So just by doing that process, it brought that emotions up for me. And then I realized then with art, we actually don't realize sometimes the emotions and the feelings that we put into a piece. And I felt that the frames are the containers, and it contains the image. The image is not just a picture or a painting. The image has conscious and subconscious thoughts, conscious and subconscious feelings, conscious and subconscious emotions. And it can invoke an awful lot of things, not just for one person, but for anybody that actually looks at that piece. So the first piece I started on is along inside here. And I decided then, while I was doing the work, that it had to be a frame upon a frame upon a frame of some of them. Some of the work actually contains journal that I've had to write along the way of doing the art therapy. So even just by using a journal, and what that journal contained ended up turning into an art piece. So it just shows you how much and how far and how deep art therapy can go. So I just want to say I'm very passionate about this kind of stuff, and I just get totally into it, and I just lose myself in the work. Some of the work that is untitled is what had came out from me, and the stuff that is titled what had to be done. So some work is titled and some work is not. So all I want to say is thank you so much for taking some of your time out tonight. I know you could be sitting in watching EastEnders or whatever, Netflix, just to come and have a look at my work. I am so, so grateful. Thank you all for coming out. And don't be shy. If there's any questions you want answers to, I'm here. So just enjoy. Thank you.